on our first episode of The Tonight Show that we did.
Yes, I was.
And I bring this up all the time.
Legendary episode.
It was super fun, right?
Do you even recall, do you have any vivid memories? Is it just sort of like a... You know, people say you miss out on your own wedding, like you don't actually experience it. Did you, do you,
do
you
have... I do kind of forget. I remember, like, going in the hallway right before I was coming out, and it was just...
Oh, no, I have such an unbelievable experience of you in that hallway.
You do?
Never mind your memories. Let's talk about mine.
Wait, what were your memories? Yeah. Was it just...
What I recall and what I actually shared with you via email was that it was an occasion when... You knew later on you would say, yeah, I was there that night. And you were in your dressing room, and we were all in the hall waiting. People really massively famous, not me included, massively famous, you know, legends. It was the legend ball.
It was and Tina Fey. It was everybody.
Lady Gaga.
Lady Gaga was there. Mariah Carey.
Mariah Carey, who stole, she put her the $100 bill in her bosom, which I was going to do, but that's cool because, for anyway, that's, it's not about me, it's about you.
No, but you end up doing a cooler thing because
I put it in my shoe.
You came out, you put it in your shoe and took your shoe out. Yeah, old school. I love it.
But anyway, you came out of your dressing room. And you were being walked on either side by what I imagine was like almost like a handler, like offering you up into the world, showing you the path. And you it was literally like you left a boy and then you came back a man. You know, like it was like, you know what I mean? It was like today.
No, yeah.
But it was but it was extremely, were any of you guys, you were all here, right?
Yeah.
So you didn't,
no, they didn't
see,
see,
but it was, I'm not describing it accurately enough to sort of convey this.
It was electric,
kind of,
it was great.
Yeah, it was really cool.
Colbert was here, and it was just fun, and everybody,
we
you walk by, they're all
you.
Like, they're almost like, it was almost like a Soul Train line where people are on both sides, and I was kind of dancing down the middle, like.
And you know, I think also you have, there's so much, you have so much goodwill. People feel so fondly toward you and about you. And so I think everybody wanted that night to be a terrific success for you.
Yeah.
So,
and my
anyway.
My mom and dad were in the audience.
Oh, that's right.
And my dad heckled me.
That's right.
What is wrong with you? Why would you do that?
Setting the tone.
Yeah, he really did. He really did. And then I got to see you at this, it was a night for Brian Lord at Lincoln Center.
Yeah.
And you, everyone who's a great, he's just a great human, great agent, great guy. And you got up and sang the song from Annie.
I did. And per his request, not because I thought of it.
Yeah, well, you don't come on. I always want you to sing more, but you're such not a show off. You're very shy. If I see you at any time, you and Matthew are like, hi, guy. And you're like, hi.
Like, pay no attention. Pay no attention.
But you sang it. It was so beautiful and heartbreaking.
Thanks.
And I was like, oh, I loved it. I love your voice.
That's a very seductive song. Like, anybody could sing that song.
I never knew that song.
Oh, it's. Do you guys know NYC from Annie? Yeah. There must be somebody. Do you guys know it? It's one of the great. It's a tribute to the city, but it's from a different time and place. So the kind of things that they are describing are slightly different, but the feeling is very sentimental, right? And romantic about our beloved city.
I want to say I was crying, but I mean, I was really, everyone's moved. It was really beautiful.
Thank you.
It was really nice.